Hello, welcome. Steve Watson here at Someday Farm doing a heavy bag drill. This particular drill would work just fine with a hanging heavy bag. I happen to have a standing heavy bag. And as with all heavy bag drills, you want to make sure that you have hand wraps and or bag gloves. So the idea with this is it's a two strike practice, but mostly the practice is about range, structure, and shifting. So range, structure, shifting, or shifting, range, structure, I guess, you know, structure, shifting, range, whatever the order might seem to be best. So initially we're going to hit the bag. Doesn't really matter to me which hand, which type of hit, you know, which style. Doesn't really make a difference to me, right? So once the bag is hit, the bag's going to deflect from its vertical, and then of course it's going to rebound and deflect to a similar degree in the other direction. And of course it's going to do this for a little bit. For here, I'm really just thinking about the first hit and then the first rebound, which are the highest amplitude movements of the bag, because of course it's going to slow into stillness. So the first hit, I hit it and it's going to deflect and then it's going to come back. So what I want to do here, A, I can do the first hit just static. So I hit it pretty straightforward, right? I can do that hit, you know, pretty powerfully, a whole lot of body, a whole lot of turning. That's also fine. I can do that hit with a shift, right? And I can also do that hit with a shift and a step, right? So however you want to do that first hit is fine. You're probably going to match that with the second hit that we'll talk about in a moment. But it doesn't really matter to me what that first hit is. The point is we set up the deflection and the rebound, and then we can do our practice. So if it's more fun or whatever to get the hit this way, that's fine. If you want to be static, if you want to have just a little bit of shift and turn, great. So at any rate, I get my first hit and the bag's deflected. The next thing I want to do is have established for myself a range that I want to hit at, right? So short, medium, long, whatever it is, doesn't really make a difference to me, but you want to know ahead of time what that is, okay? And then probably have an idea what sort of strikes fit those ranges, right? So a close elbow for a close strike, right? A hooking motion for a medium strike, an extended palm or fist or finger strike for a longer strike, something like that would be fine. So I have an idea, the range that I'm going to be using for my second hit, okay? So I hit the bag, I'll just do it static. I hit the bag and it's going to end up deflected quite similar to how it is now, so about here. And if I want a long range strike, my work is to shift. This is about where that bag's going to end up. But a long range strike would have me shifted here so that when I do that strike, I'm meeting the bag pretty cleanly, right? Doesn't matter if I have a little bit of bite on the bag or a little bit of brush on the bag. The idea is I want to kind of come into that range. The range that I expect, the range that I plan on, the range that I have tools for. So here I am, one, when that deflects, I need to move back and have my range change, my structure, right? My tools ready to bear when the bag is there, because it's going to change its range as we, you know, as time goes on. So I want to have a sense that I only have one chance to get this right. So I hit it and then I hit it, right? So hit, move just to short range, and that's where the bag wasn't coming in further. I prefer to do this strike with kind of lateral strikes, this drill with lateral strikes rather than here, because I can kind of cheat. If I was doing a short range strike, but the bag was destined to come here, my short range strike might kind of stop it. And I can kind of lie to myself thinking, yeah, my range was great, when the reality is it was trying to get over here. Whereas if I was doing this, it's much more clear to me at the moment of impact. Was that thing destined to hit me in the belly, or was it just about to stop and I ranged it well? Right? So one, two, doesn't matter if it's left, right, right, left, doesn't really make a difference. So one, two, having a sense of that range. So we keep our structure, we shift in step, and then we deploy what we expect to deploy. So that's your homework. Be safe, be confident, and more important, be competent. Thank you.